a wonderland. Your body is a wonderland. Welcome back to San Antonio Living. The growing outrage against a single mother of 14 children has become a huge national story. 33-year-old Nadia Solman gave birth last month to octuplets, and now the California fertility clinic that helped her get pregnant is under investigation. Of course, the California Medical Board is trying to decide whether or not this clinic broke medical guidelines. And joining us this morning to talk about this situation is a doctor from right here in San Antonio, Dr. Francisco Arredondo with the Reproductive Medical Associates. How are you today?
Good morning, Shelley. We're doing great.
So first of all, we have to mention you're not Nadia's doctor. You know nothing about this
Absolutely.
Woman other what you have read and investigated, but you are a fertility doctor.
Yes, that is correct. We are here in San Antonio in the Stone Oak area, RMA of Texas.
And let's talk about first how this happened, because there's two kinds of fertilization, and it's in vitro and
insemination,
okay.
Artificial
and
insemination.
What's the difference?
A lot of people confuse these two, and it's very important that you clear this out. The in vitro fertilization, you obtain the eggs of the woman and you fertilize them with the sperm of her partner, and once you have an embryo, you transfer this embryo inside the woman. In the artificial insemination, you actually the fertilization occurs in vivo inside the woman.
Okay.
So you get the sperm from the husband, you prepare it, you wash it, and you put it inside the woman's uterus. And once you have that, you basically have no control of how many were fertilized.
Okay.
In this particular case, in the case in California, was an in vitro fertilization. So the person had total control of the number of embryos.
Wow. So when you say total control, it surprises me that there were 8 babies born from this pregnancy.
And you are not alone in being surprised. The whole community is very shocked because of the fact that there are very clear guidelines by the American Society of Reproductive Medicine where you basically limit the amount of embryos that you transfer in each age group, as well as the prognosis of this group.
And we've got a graphic to show that information. These guidelines, basically, the most, in the most extreme case, the most embryos that you're going to transfer would be 4.
Would be actually 5,
four
but that will be in a person that is more than 40 years of age, has several failure of in vitro fertilization attempts. In this particular case, she had previous successes, so at RMA of Texas, this woman should have had only 1, maximum 2 embryos transfer. So it was, if the allegedly number of embryos that were transferred is correct, it was a very clear break of the guidelines.
Now, when we say guidelines, there's no law in place. It's just a guideline that's put out there. So what kind of trouble could this doctor get into?
It is difficult. It will depend on the board trying to, Medical Board of California, trying to prove that he has broken the standard of care.
Mm-hmm.
And that is going to be, I think, a challenge to prove. But certainly there are no laws enforcing this like happens in other countries like mm-hmm. Sweden where actually it's mandatory to transfer only 1.
When a patient comes to you and they say, I want to get pregnant, I want to have 8 babies, what would you counsel them to do?
Absolutely. When something like that happens, one of the other issues is that patients, when we suspect that they have a certain psychological need, like this woman certainly does have,
mm-hmm.
apparently, and she actually has accepted this, you have very good counselors, and there's a couple of very good ones here in town in San Antonio that could help us out to evaluate psychologically this person and basically deny the care for transferring 8 embryos or 6 embryos.
Because that is an option. You can turn away a patient, right?
Absolutely. Well, more than turning away, you really have to educate it about the risk, because a lot of people out there are very happy about having twins, etc. But twins are not normal pregnancies. They carry a certain risk. And the tendency in our field is to transfer only 1 embryo, at the most, sometimes 2. But it's important also to clarify, Shelley, that this is an extremely rare event.
Mm-hmm.
I was mentioning to you that this is like an airplane accident.
Mm-hmm.
There's thousands of airplane flights out there, and there's once in a while an accident. Last year alone, there were 120-plus IVF cycles, and everything went uneventful. So
right.
This is really something that is out of the ordinary, and we need to underscore that.
We should say that this one particular situation has really given in vitro, and this particular doctor, a very bad name, but there are tons of doctors around the country who practice under the guidelines and do this all the time.
That is correct. And perhaps being positive, this gives us the opportunity to educate the public and also to tell them that they should go to a board-certified infertility physician, which this individual is not.
That's just the craziest thing right there. All right, if you would like to find out a little bit more about in vitro fertilization, if you'd like to get a list of board-certified physicians here in San Antonio, this is the man that you need to talk to, Dr. Francisco Arredondo, again, the medical director with RMATX, and that, again, is the Reproductive Medical Associates. You can find them online there. They're out in Stone Oak, and you can give them a call at 210-FERTILE is the phone number, 210-FERTILE. Thank you so much for coming by today. We appreciate it.
It is my pleasure. Thank you.
Very nice to meet you.